So the biggest initiative from a skill development standpoint is the project that we run with Tata Trust, where we skill high school graduates on different job roles in healthcare space and get them jobs in hospitals and diagnostic centers. We now have 42 institutes across 17 different states, and we train about 2,500 students every year who go through this program. About 97% of them pass the program, which is a third-party healthcare sector skills council exam. And we are able to place about 80% at this point in time, and aspirationally we want to go to 100% placements. So that's the flagship program that we run from a skill development standpoint. See, the biggest challenge is that people still think of skill development, education as a social cause. And that takes away a lot from sustainability. If you have to create a sustainable skill development intervention, you have to look at it from a corporate perspective of how do you sustain and how do you scale. And which is one of the prime reasons why we have been able to scale it up very quickly in the last couple of years. So that's one. And the second is more from aspiration of the student standpoint. So you have to make sure that the job roles that you're creating, the jobs that you're creating, the level of salary that you are paying those guys is in line with the aspiration of the youth. As long as you can take care of these two, which is create a sustainable model which is based on the principles of cooperation, and you're able to provide the youth and the population something that they can aspire to, something they can live up to, I think those two things are the biggest challenges that you need to solve for. Well, like I said, I mean, everything sustainable that I know, you know, there are obviously some exceptions, comes out of a business model. So one example of what we did is with Tata Trust is to create a revolver loan, which means that you give loans out to kids, they pay you back if they get a job and when they get a job, and the payback that you get becomes a part of the pool which can be used to fund the next generation of students. So if you're able to create this fund and you're able to sustain it over a period of time, then you don't have to rely on donor funding or the CSR funding. Then you're creating a self-sustaining engine. And that's what I feel if you start looking at all of this through a non-social lens, while the cause may be social, your business model doesn't have to be.